All right, Unit 1, Standard of Care, Hazmat Material Incident Management. Unit 1, Standard of Care. Introduction, incident commanders of the hazmat material, for the hazmat responsible for the hazard, health and safety of everyone on the trip, that include the personnel of the fire, police, the public works, emergency medical, local, state, federal agency, the general public, the development of the standard of care to help to ensure the proper response of the training, with the response of the incident commanding officer, respond with successful operation, develop a strategic goal, tactical object, with tactical method to bring the incident to safe completion. The accomplishment of the incident command must have the workable decision-making process in place. The course will provide you with the unexpected accept the process, along with safety officer, if the incident command responds with the implementing into the incident action plan, with the responsible with the assisting with the development of the incident command, with maintaining with the paperwork, with the documents, all aspects of the incident command, responsible with conducting the debriefing, the critique of the incident. Chemical incident may expand with the bar beyond with the means of the more jurisdictional control of the incident command, must know with the where to call with the assistance with the how to step with the unified command with the new manual of the man to help with the honestly with the during the incident. Chemical emergency challenge with the incident command with ways unheard of a few years ago with the must now. Chemical response with definite actions with the rule with the all respond with the know with the respective rules and respond with the fact check with the chemical incident with the help with the may lead with the disastrous result. The one type of the response with where the incident command makes the certain the situation has to involve with be taken in an offensive of the action. Purpose of this course is to help the hazmat incident command understand to do with the response with the liability emergency response with the incident command coordinated with the integrated all phases of the incident effectively. The coordination integrated curve of the effect of the incident with the management system based on the fire service, the concept of the products, or some of the procedures that arose as they relate to the current law within the standard of the course will examine the responsibility tasks associated with the analyzing of the incident, with the planning, and the implementing, evaluating, operating progress, terminating the incident while emphasizing legal aspects of liability for the facing of the incident command, the tax will of the inquiry. Task will incorporate the precedent on scene post incident operation. The course will not intend to teach incident command system, nor has operational methods or tasks. It's a course on incident command liability issues. Effective with the response of the emergency to disaster, they're becoming increasingly complex. They are involved with the preparing with the response of the emergency, called with the natural man-made events, with the event of the terrorist activity, the need for the understanding of the communicate weather pattern, the human behavior, the chemical computers, transportation laws and the agency regulations, public, private, the nonprofit, the management, the employee, with as well as the volunteers have become increasingly aware of the legal issues that have an impact with emergency management. All parties involved with the concern with the liability to prepare for, and they are called to respond with the disaster. Is increased with the concern of the potential liability, increased greater concern of the personal financial risk, the general trend to delay, get associated society with the greatest number of the suits with against for the public organization, respond with increased the person the liability of the threat. State and federal law provides meanings of the filing claim to the against the governmental union of their employee with their agent with injuries resulting in the action preparation for and in response to the disaster emergency. Law includes both state and federal statute with the constitutional provisions on court decision. All complex laws is based on the principle of clarifying individual although complex of the law is based on the principle of the clarified individual responsibility of the human identified with intended to provide with an entry with the principle of the law through the case of the example of the emergency of the disaster, identified with the areas of the law with the effect of the liability with emergency planning activities, with understanding the potential liability problem involved in the emergency management, can seek guidance, legal counsel, how to avoid the minimized exposure, sovereign immunity, or the principle of sovereign immunity of the individual's harm of the action for the governmental cannot be recovered the damage of the state with the political subdivision unless the government agree with the pay of the claim. However, the many of the states will no longer subscribe to the sovereign immunity from the 1960s to 1980s. More and more states abolish sovereign immunity. Each of the states defines extent of liability to resolve the survivor sovereign immunity is either retained or abolished, adapted in some other way. State law provides immunity in one or more ways. State Tort Act, State Emergency Management Act, Discretion Immunity Act, Discretion Immunity, Governmental Property, Proprietary Immunity, Public Safety Provisions, Official for the Firefighter, Police, Public Service Personnel. On the other immunity may be lawful the gross negligence, initial misconduct, malfeasance, not immunity of the private contractor, not immunity for the response to the incident. A tort is an act of the harm, act that harms another that occurred with the personal committed with the act of the fail for the act without resolve of the result of the another that harm directly or indirectly with the tort may lead to civil action, personal injury, property damage of the tort, including the internal intentional act of negligence, strikes with their absolute liability. Civil action provided with the meaning of personal harm with the by another the compensated with the personal love of the many of the field with the individual harm with the public human has should be some degree with the compensated with the civil action can provide with the base of the distributing liability. Negligence, negligence, unintentional invasion of the power and personal injury that is protected by law, where the actor with the fault of the actor conduct with the legal cause of the injury, suffered injury, and again, if the, does not establish liability. Per se, a person owned the duty to another exercise care for the governmental units employed by their most often sued for the damage of the alleged negligence. Elements of negligence. Negligence found with a common element of the absence of the proof of the one element will defeat with the finding of liability. The existence of the duty recognized by the law by for the person with the governmental employee with the same care with the defined with the common law based on the judicial decision or by statute factual confirmed with the same of the care of the care of the duty, the actual cost and loss of the damage of the injured party. Casual connection between the act of the wrongdoer, his or her negligence, and the result of the injury of the third party. All negligence have the elements of the common, the absent three for the one element of the defeating and finding liability. A statute may establish duty or standard care. Local government units failed to prepare emergency response plan by liable for the injuries caused by the failure to prepare a plan. Examples. All right, let's look at a couple of examples. The merchant responding with the drive of the merchant vehicle, the reckless man with the disregard of the safety of all other vehicles, the resolve of the respond with the vehicle, plow with the other vehicle, stop with the internship that does not confident negligence, less supply with the elements, lift with it. What was their duty? Yes, all license, driver they have with the common law of duty to drive safely, where was their failure to carry out the duty? Yes, was their injury? Yes, to stop the vehicle, if the casual link was between 2 and 3, yes, is there negligence? Local emergency planning committee, the county failed to develop the local emergency response plan, although required a state emergency management act with the track overturn of the spelling of the firming. Nitric oxide, local response with emergency management, even the respondents are with a few of the response after the very slow, but the cleanup take for the long time. Many of the businesses are shut down during the emergency. Business owners fail with claims again with the county for the loss of the business during the incident. Whether their duty to the F, they state the law requires blame with the failure to carry out the duty. If there is no local complaint, what is their injury? Yes, there is loss of business income. And if the casual link with the element of 2 and 3, apparently. Is there negligence probable with the plaintiff that comes in for the court for the failure to carry out the duty with the cause of the injury? Second example show that the claim of the negligence has not always been cut out and dry, but the outcome of limited litigation hinges on which side of it makes the more convincing case. Liability. Liability of the state being liable to legal to be responsible for something of the one should be do or avoid. Federal, state, and local laws exist regarding liability. Federal laws include Occupational Safety Health Act, the Reservation, Conservation, and Recovery Act, and the Super Amendment, the Reauthorization Act, Title III, with the Emergency Planning Committee, and the Right to Know Act, the state laws vary for the may be more stringent for the federal law, but they cannot be stringent for the severe immunity. Sovereign immunity implied by the collective the governments have, and they increase the denial over the past several years of the legal decision all levels of governments. There are different kinds of liability. The first, governmental, with the vicarious liability, but the second is individual liability, governmental, vicarious liability. Most states recognize the governmental liability, negligent, and the commission of the agent, for the employee, with the like, for the scoping of the duty, for the public employee, with liability, for the employee, with the action passed, for the government union, for the employee, with the under the theory, with the normal known. For cautious limited with the example of the presented above, the employer may be vicariously liable to the employee with negligence. Liability with the government agencies may be limited, however, in 3 ways. The first of the three of the immunity discretion acts with the means of the government unit may be immune with the liability explained to employees action over their nominal operational example, the would-be acts depending on the judicial decision maker. The intent is free of the public official for the free of the tour. Liability of the judgment resolved the harm to another. The next form of the immunity, the governmental proprietary immunity with the means of the sum of the government distinguishes between the governmental function of the traditional performer of the government of these functions perform proprietary nature of the traditional performer of the private sector of the form of the group that include the activities of the essential traditional performer of the government activity of firefighting policing fall into this category. The final where government liability is limited to statutory immunity but the meaning of the state has included specific provision of the statute of the recognized immunity of the tort claim with the term of the situation, for example, the some state of the recognition of the immunity of the emergency activities addition of the provision state comprehensive the liability statutes. States and also include provision of the Emergency Management Act. Individual liability. The government unit may not be liable for the employee of the action if the action of the outside of the scope of his or her duty of the acts of the Miles Act, regardless of the guards of the right of the others, under these circumstances, the employee may be liable, individually liable, and the government unit not liable. Immunity provisions of most state statutes will include the provision protected for the acts of the employee, representative of the employee with a civil claim, except with the willful misconduct of the gross negligence, intentional harm of the others, willful wanton misconduct of which takes on the aspect of the highly unreasonable action with extremely departure from the ordinary care from which harm and injury is apparently involved with conduct with the intent of the cause of the injury and another, but conduct is more of the mere mistaking result of the experience of the confusion, and there must be more of the mere thoughtfulness and intention. No doubt, the increased concern with the overlap of the realized with the hazard response that makes the incident command suspect with a civil claim However, there are factors to which work. The incident command favored the one with the immunity of some of the state laws provided by the best protection, careful planning of the response. And the remainder of this course is also about this issue. The Appendix A Student Manual 1 through 81 has more detailed explanation than liability allows. All right, laws. Summary, laws. Federal Occupational Self-Safety Act, the Reservation Conservation Recovery Act, the Environmental Protection Conservation Recovery Act. State statutes may be more stringent than federal laws and nevertheless vary from state to state. Local codes and ordinance may be more stringent than state laws, nevertheless vary locality. All right, National Fire Protection Association professional standard with no direct relation with the federal state law, the federal state agency reference of the professional standard with the drafting regulation for the standards contributed to the standard of the care. 7. Remove the consent of the government cannot be even sued unless they agree with it, and to be even in the recent year, increasingly denied. Tort acts of the harm other with a civil suit with the refile with the curve with the acts on one fails. The acts come to serve the harm direct with the personal injury, the indirect property loss, the negligence of the unit, potential invasion of the personal the injury of the protected law with the four elements may exhibit the problem removed negligence. Existence, duty, failure to carry out duty, actual law of the damage, casual relationship between the duty and injury with the third party. Immunity. Immunity may be granted with the state with the tort act with the state emergency act with the negligence of the provided with the normal immunity with the government unit may be liable to negligence exists. The suit may be filed within the state with court of the government unit obligated to pay the claim with the general or the employees may be held responsible. There are no punitive signs. Liability of the state being liable, legal, responsible, the duty with the responsible, the act provided service to perform a duty. Vicarious liability with the government agency of the employer, resume with the responsible, the action with official with the employee with the volunteers. Liability with the government agency may be limited to discretionary immunity, governmental proprietary immunity, statutory immunity, state emergency management act, individual liability. If that may exhibit the action, official employee with a volunteer with consent of the grossly negligent of the action must be malfeasance for the office of the private contractor occurs with the harm of the non-public servant's volunteer with the spiller caused with the harm, not the responder. All right, planning. Need for the planning. With a major disaster, with the curve of the Buffalo, India, with the wheel curve of the 4,000, with the injury of the 200,000 people that were rare, with the help of the hazmat spill, with the relief increase, with the frequency of the problem, the hazmat material multiplied many times over the past few years, with more chemical meme, with the problem with the transport stored and used. Today, there are 12 million chemical substances registered for the chemical abstraction, with the total increase of 50,000 per month during the 1980s, with the concern of the most adjacent. Most accidents involved the hazmat material growing among the citizens and the public officials, with many concerned with the hazmat, into the most. Serious threat facing local jurisdictions counteract with the threat of the federal law of regulation based on the Environmental Protection Conservation Recovery Act and overall community and planning. Information is an essential component of the planning process to ensure the reduce the impact of the hazard incident and the systematic process of reviewing performance of the previous incident and identifying unsafe practices for the implementing policy change that is possible to prevent the potential injury for the future incident. The incident command must ensure the information and about jurisdictions complete and accurate frequent updates to keep the information current. The section deals with the pre-planning with the technical incident command with the rule not part of the planning with the committee with the imperative with the potential for the incident command with the critical all aspects of the response of the four with all the comments of the planner incident command will be called on operate with one plan with the trip plan with the incorporated with the complete but not in compliance with the Occupational Safety Health Administration Title 29 Code Federal Regulation 1910-120 based on impossible goals of the incident command must be forward with the need of the chain of the plan the change. Needed change to the plan with the responsible incident command who accept the faulty of the plan with the commitment that they have a total question of the answer after the incident. So now the incident cannot be properly handled because of the faulty plan will be played with the incident command playing with a bad situation. If the actions are taken and do not comply with the regulation, like legal action of the injured parties, then will resolve the section. Offer the background information for the planning of the pursuit of the requirement to not complete with the planning guide. With the incident command, some of the incident members of the local emergency planning commission that will be responsible for planning as well as the response. Incident indicated the incident command shall understand where and how the plans come into play with being whether informing they contain whether information they contain and the value of the there may be. Planning benefits. Planning provided by the incident command with the knowledge factor that will involve the influence of the hazmat incident of the knowledge include the likely location of the product involved with the path of the dispersal of the leaf, the chemical with the major benefit of the knowledge with the increase of the incident command's ability to protect life with environmental property during the incident. Planning proper procedures such as the top of the core for the early discovery of the national response team has a measurement management planning guide NRT1 identified as the area with the concern of the finding of the hazard communicates faces of the risk of the associated with the head of the jurisdiction, vulnerability of the hazard of the primary benefit of the planning process. Another variable benefit is during the planning process, the rules of response for the various agents of the response of the sniff of the wave with the defining of the reduce of the confusion and the turf battles during the incident of the retrieve of the agency. All of the response of the responders must perform the operation while working with the integrated response. Experience show the response of the incident of the 10 with the ignore of the plan of the prepared only one agent of the one person of the emergency response with the crowd of the trust of the coordinate of the corporation. Of among the responsible for the need to know whether the responsible for the activities were capable of performing what activities, personal interaction related to the game and the knowledge and working with it together were developing an updating plan with the primary opportunity for cooperative interaction among responsible with the incident expanded the local capabilities have of the plan include with the multiple aid agreements. Simplify the response with the outside assistance. Adequate plans identify provide assistance with the performance and person who become the key people of the hazmat into the wherever they come to the same local jurisdiction during the planning stage of the emergency response with the eve of the local agency with the front of the air with the mutual aid agreement they receive the response with guide provide with the company with the chemical plan with the trucking firm with the railroad store with the transfer of the hazmat material with the air identify with these personal training levels that are set for the response with capabilities are noted. The planning team, the Environmental Planning Conservation Recovery Act, which required the governor of the State Emergency Response Commission, the Emergency Planning District, local emergency planning commissions, identified by the agency for the mandatory role of the planning process, successful planning requirements committee involved throughout the process of the enlisting and the cooperation of all of the parties directing to the concern with the hazard of the material, the improving the plan, the making of the plan, of the probe, of the increase of the likelihood of the effectiveness of the response. The team approach planning has benefits for the team bringing with the expertise, the variety, with the strength of the problem. The team approach for the grief, the accuracy, the completeness of the plan, with the ensure the reflectiveness, consensus with the entire community, with the shore of the plan, moment of the community, leave of the business, leave of the agency, with the more likely to develop through the team approach. Team members must include the major city manager, head county government, and the other jurisdictional representative of the fire law, informants from the emergency management, the transportation, media, environmental group, of the emergency medical service, the hospital, with the health department, the agency. Industry must include the other recommended representative of the utility part of the situation, sanitation, the other community group, of the voluntary organization, such as Red Cross and Salvation Army. And select the members of the team should consider the following factors. The members of the group must have the ability to the commitment of the resources to get the job done. They must have the authority to speak with their agencies. They must possess and have the access with a wide range of expertise relating with the community, with the industrial facility, with the transportation, with the mechanism of the emergency response, with the response planning. Members of the group must agree with the purpose of the work cooperatively with one group, one another. The group must represent all of the elements of the community that have substantial interest in the reduction of the risk of the hazard material with the compound brands, the list of the potential team, and include with the NRT 1, page 13. Should the State Emergency Response Commission with the local emergency planning committee required member of the manager city government and recommended to the utility county government head park, the Department of Sanitation, Fire Law, Red Cross, Law Enforcement School, Emergency Management, Environmental Service, the Transportation, Media, Health, and Industry, and Industry. Role of the local of the government. Local government is the first line with the defense for the most of the emergency for the civil reason they have the critical role of the development of the emergency preparedness. Local governments have responsible for the protection of the health and safety of local with the policy of the fire department, for example. Often lead agency to respond with the hazmat release of the local of the government may function with the mediator to remove the sometime with the coming with the idea of the group that is involved. Planning respond with the clarifying the roles of both planners with the respond with the local government to have the avoid danger of the obviously duplication of the efforts to ensure coordination between the public and private agencies. Local governments have the authority to raise funds with the equipment and personnel with the requirement of the emergency response with new regulation ordinance with the provide with the funding with the equipment and personnel with the authority of local government to support them from both executive level and legislative branch with the sense of the essential of the planning with the government leave with the give the adequate with the authority of the response with the emergency planning. Step of the planning. After the planning team, a number of the leaders of the assembled, the team has addressed several of the tasks with the completion of the tasks and ensure the sound base for the written plan with the nine base of the steps that taken before any of the work. Any other work, let's see, step in the detail of the NRT 1. Search out, view, and review existing plan. With the response plan now, and youth that need only the altering reflect the need of the hazmat incident, even if the no longer plan is in youth the helpful to starting plan. Any of the plan will provide with the team with the information on the deal. Review the plan and ensure the proper coordination and relay with the plan. Reduce the work efforts of building upon with modifying existing emergency and planning the response information. Also, contradiction between the plan with the youth of the redundant plans avoided. Review and plans cognizant organizations such as state local emergency management agencies, local environmental agencies, state local transportation agency, state local public health agencies, fire departments, public departments, police departments, public service agencies, volunteer group, this Red Cross, the local industry and industrial association, regional official for the federal agency, environmental protection agency, federal emergency management, or FEMA. Hazard is analysis critical element of the hazard, incident planning with the hazard, and also the information gap with the provided the factor, but on basis of the set priority for the planning, also provided the documentation supporting hazard plans, response efforts. Three steps within this process: hazard identification, vulnerability assessment, risk analysis, the different analysis, sometimes with different meaning, with the sometimes wrongfully used and interchangeable, commonly accepted definitions. Hazard identification: identification of hazard material found with the jurisdiction for the potential causing injury, the life of the damage of the property, the environment, the vulnerability analysis, particularly the life of the property, environmental injury. Damage if the hazard manifests is fully potential. Risk analysis of the probability injury level of the damage of the property and environment will occur if the hazard manifests is full potential. Hazard identification. Complete hazard identification. Examine all of the hazard vulnerability risk of the neither possible nor desirable planning. Decide the level of thoroughness of the need of the focus of the analyze of the most of the common, the most severe hazards. Hazard the material of the common, the most intensive of the few, with the prevalent, the most convenient of the gasoline of the other flame of the blast, liquid chlorine and ammonia, hydrous ammonia, hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid, are chemicals most involved with the incident. Certain industrial facility most pose the specifically additional have of the hydrogen, fluorine, and oil refining these large quantities of the monomers and plastic manufacturing the hazard identification, even the character of the nature of the problem, pose the hazard for the material with the information to develop, will direct planning team toward the proper community of the planning with the proper hazard identification, develop the information for each of the facility with the transportation situation, such as the type of the quantity of the material that either being stored at the facility or being moved down on the street with the highway identification storage over the primary route of the transportation curve, further examination for the hazard more likely to occur during an incident. Hazard identification, first step in planning with the planner should complete it before any of the additional work plan begins. Vulnerability analysis. Vulnerability analysis identified with the prone damage of the head of the release occurs. Show the summary of the information major have identified with the term of the hazard identification process. Planners need to find information for the number of the people expected with the vulnerable area, as well as where the residents employed with the facilities and others. Planners are determined to both private and the public property of the faith of the possibility of the damage to the animals made with the essential systems such as power, water, food, medical services, and transportation corridor facilities, as well as sensitive areas like hospitals, nursing homes, schools, daycare centers. Final planners determine the extent of the vulnerability zone with the spill and the relief, the condition, the influence of the size of the zone, the condition, size of the spill, the wind direction, weather condition, water course, topography, and the like. Risk analysis. Risk analysis assessing the probability of the injury damage occurring with the community suggests the vulnerability analysis of the relief of the hazard material of the planning team of the worst case scenario to develop the risk analysis. Have the describe in occurrence of probability over the terms such a low, moderate, high, with the provide with a reasonable estimate of the base of the best available information. The risk analysis will provide planning team with the information probability of the relief of the will occur with the unusual environmental condition in the area of the floodplain is a primary example. Type of the harm to the people that are acute, chronic, and delayed respond with exposure to the hazard chemicals associated high risk group. Type of the danger is probably repairable, the permanent, with the type of the environmental damage classified, recoverable, or permanentable. Planners must emphasize the developing reasonable estimate of the base of the best available. The expertise of the two publications could be helpful with the planning with the technical guide of the hazard analysis of the fixed facility with emerging planning. Extremely high with the disruptive and chemical hazard analysis procedure for transportation. The public is confined with the FEE and the FEMA and the EPA and the DOT. Community research of the applicable of these third step of the hazard of the analysis of the planning team must evaluate with the community's preparing for the preservation of the response or explore the capability of the beginning to identify with all the sources, include public and private voluntary organization and survey with all planners need the subject and need about the availability of any subject, supplies building and the response may be needed. Facility team, but the most facilities have the hazard material have the trained response team, and any of the technician level of some of the team members that may normally be able to do the at all time of the teams usually will have available a supply of the equipment that is capability of the chemical on site. Transport is now the community resource available to transport hazard material hazard wave of the planners determine the equipment available to transport with their cleanup capability of the training level of has community. Finally, the planner determine the capability of the community reach for the ability of the general and the effect of the response of the point and include all of the government agency plus other community reach for the job of the hub, hospital, public housing, schools, communication, public utilities, essentially identify the possibility of response personnel such as fire, public, and police, and determine the local competency. Also, took and look for any specialized expertise in the response team. Roles and responsible. The keepers of the planning identify the roles responsible for the various agencies. The three main reasons for performing the task that allow the efficiency of the available reach for the incident command who have been responsible for the action during the incident. Prove the coordination, assume the responding unit that there is no survival of the conflicts over the who will perform the specific task. It provides overall command of the incident and proceed with the chain of the command as the incident escalates. Normally, same first responders of the fire and police at the scene of the incident, whatever hazard. Emergency functions differ only with slightly hazard to hazard. For example, the procedure warning of the public to mask chemical reliefs are a little different from those of warning an impounding, impending tornado or flood. One can eliminate most confusion and duplication of the effort playing with all the hazards. And adding specifically annex of the industrial individual hazards such as hazards include floods, storms, hazmat, and incidents, other current concerns. Civil Prepared Guidance Book, CPG 1A, Guide for the Development of State and Local Emergency Operation Plans, provided the guidance of multiple hazard plans. Features of the plan, feature of the essential in the plan with the concept of the operation, brief statement of the precisely with which accepted to be accomplished with an incident with courage critical for each of the responding organizations, show the governing principle of rules, responsibility for the available for the responsibility among the responders. Plan needs check label for the respondent for the use of the scene of the list, ensure that nothing is forgotten accidentally, we serve the part with the required written documentation for the incident. Plan must establish standard operating procedures, standard operating guidelines, standard operation procedures, standard operating guidelines. Offer guidelines identify the specific actions and methods to be used for the handling of the incident. Standard operation procedure and standard operation guidelines should be integrated within the employer's emergency response plan, local emergency plan, commission plan, and planner incident command must ensure that the integration occurs with the review and exercises. Planning the evaluation. An experience show that many of the community's mistake with the presuming the writing of the plan with the guarantees adequate prepared for the emergency response with the first responder did not evaluate the plan there and exercise as soon as possible. Multiple agency exercises not only provide an effective means for the testing of the plan, but also provide technical training for the responder with given the age of the responder with a better understanding of the rule of the responder for the end of the new plan and the testing of the plan. Thoroughly exercises all the reveal of the fault and uncover the misunderstanding before they manifest themselves during the incident. Exercise are most helpful with the meeting with all the participants, the debrief of the criteria for the review of the strength of the weakness of the planning operation, as well as performance of the involved with the parameters are going to be amend the plan to correct any deficiency based on the result of the exercise review and the criteria. Our local emergency planning commission plan elements. The 9 elements of planning with a hazmat, the Environmental Preservation Conservation Recovery Act will require that each of the emergency response plan to include at least the following elements for the known particular order with the identification facility of the hazard chemicals or with the emergency of the planning district. Identification routes likely to be used for the transportation and substance list of the extremely hazardous substance. Identification of additional facilities contributing or suspect to the additional risk of the due to the proximity of the facility with the staff of the hospital and natural gas facility. 2, designation community emergency of the coordinated facility with the emergency coordinator of the WHO shall make the determination necessary to carry out the plan and description of emergency equipment facility and the community for the facility of the subject community subject to Title 3 with the requirement of identification of the personal responsible for the staff of the equipment facility. 4, procedure to provide reliable, effective, and timely notification by facility of the energy emergency coordinator of the community emergency coordinator of the person designated with an emergency plan with the public. The release has occurred with the method of determination occurring with the belief the area of the population likely to be affected such for the release. Evacuation plans include a provision, precautionary evacuation, alternative traffic routes, training programs, including schedule for the training with local emergency response with the medical personnel office. 8, procedure to be filed with facility owners, operate a local emergency and the medical personnel to be responding to any release of the such substance. Method and schedule for the exercising the emergency plan. Alright, so your standard emergency response plan. Standard state emergency response plan, elements of local emergency plan, identifying the facility, shipping around the designated facility, the community coordinator, identify with the potential effect of the facility population, public notification, release, detection, report, evacuation plan, and routing, training programs, response procedure, exercise, scheduling, methodology. Local emergency response plan, local emergency planning commission must integrate with the state emergency response plan, response commission plan. Most taking the face of the planning team and the duty to integrate with the new plan with the existing plan possible. Shovel the plans already exist and essentially coordinate with the police plan with avoid confusion. Planners need to shovel the state emergency response commission plan to make sure that the state local plans work together. State of the plan, they're available to state emergency response plan upon request. After completion of the local plan, the state emergency response plan must review the integration of the response with the plan component with both the local emergency plan. Commission plan and the State of Emergency Response Commission plan. Essentially, these plans must mesh with agency plan. Agencies include policy, fire, medical services, along with environmental facility plans. Often these agencies are called annexes. The local emergency plan commission is likely to be between planning and implementation phases, but must become part of the incident management system at incident scenes. All right, operational responsibility. The plan will identify specifically the operational duty of the responsibility of the respondent, the time of the duty of playing with the shape of the respondent, the manager for knowing exactly what they can expect during the response. Duties include the contaminant control of the hazmat, of the team of the crowd control of the environmental monitoring, sampling of the decontamination of the contaminated victim, the respondent with the medical treatment, the medical services, So for the vehicle, the responsible, the personnel, with the only and impartial list of the other duties will become apparent with the plan. The developer of the plans may most examine the facility site, the specific emergency response plan. Typically, over the prepared with the facility plan, with the compliant with the OSHA regulation, the plans are available. Local emergency plan commission from the problem with the question, the necessary local emergency plan commission with the recommendation of the facility plan will bring them into compliance with the incorporated local emergency preparedness commission plan. Facility emergency response plan, incident command plan, respond with the more detail with the otherwise possible. For example, the incident command to determine the general level of protection, even the type of the material the necessary for the existing. Examine the chemical, leave the chemical to have the facility to provide the incident command with the match for the chemical with the personal protective equipment to buy, with the consult with the chemical corporate compatibility, trouble to know the environmental protection compliance of recovery act states. Local emergency plan commission plan shall be include methods of procedure of the facility owner, operator, local emergency response, and medical personnel to respond. Release of the Environmental Protection Commission Recovery Act, Chapter 16, 11, 003C2. All right, zone. Another critical planning element if the deals with the do with zone to begin with one even to consider the maximum chemical process release spread with the maximum distance contamination might spread with this will help identify the hot zone. This is only the initial preliminary identification. However, during the incident command, the commander may need to modify the zone to protect the personnel fully. The rule is there is no contamination outside of the hot zone. Because of the presence of the contamination, specialized protective equipment and clothing are mandatory in the hot zone. Planning also must anticipate two or more decontamination, depending on the wind connection with the geographical climatological factor of the incident command. Active with one or the other decontamination curve of the warm zone with the heat, depending on the contamination of operation need with the specialized protective equipment and clothing. Third zone of the cold zone is the location suction of the such function of the command, medical cover of the staging or of the similar support task. In zone respond with the can wear normal war clothes. There are other names of these zones with hot zones off the call, the occlusion zone with the warm zone with the contamination zone, the cold zone, support zone. Area of refuge. Relate with the concept of the zone of the area of the refuge, the bank should identify with the area of the refuge, contaminated victim of the contaminated first respond with the prudence to locate with the area of the refuge. Used inside of the hot zone, but close with the parameter of the reason for the disease should be with the contaminant being in the hot zone. When planning, it was why they identify two potential areas of the refugee during the actual operation based on the same factor of the lead of the choice of the more suitable hot zone. The incident command would select a more suitable area of the refuge. Incident involved a large facility, within many of the employees of the incident command may find upon arrival of the area, many employees of the area refugee of the planning ahead of the available. Eventually can help avoid the most confusion will provide more rapid decontamination treatment of victims. Scene management. Advanced planning with it should also ensure the plan with provide the tracking system for all the personnel on scene, especially with the entry teams. Also, an incident command management system of the accountability must be in play, but include the provision of notifying all of the respondents as to whom they are accountable as well as for whom they are accountable. Since entry team members have limited the work zone, hot zone, but they must be planned set and to play for that there are no members exceeded the ultimate cumulative limit. Plan officers should be located with the staging area, the strategic location around the facility, either the number of them, the simplified of the irrational response, but I have the responding human that covered verge on open one area, they assist the backup of the performance of the proper staging area. Since security the control and proof of the responsibility agent with the head plan with its response with the procedure roadblock for the other form of the traffic control, given the responding unit, the easier for the access to the scene. Provision for the control public with the oversight seers of the maintainment of the buffer zone with the between them and the respond with the designated silver, the provision for the meeting to designate a specific point where the information will be given the regularly with the facility employer emergency response plan. OSHA Title 29-1910-122-Q1 requires a detailed response plan for each response agency dealing with the hazmat emergency. The emergency response plan should contain guidelines to describe the management of the hazmat incident, the guidelines of the standard operation procedure, the standard operation guidance to identify specific action from the responding agencies. Each responding response agency has an emergency response plan, which is integrated with the local emergency plan commission for the response agency for the more details directly with the hazmat emergency. Emergency response plan must include the limited list of the underlying elements of the emergency of the response plan and all those specific guidelines that do not exist with the supporting agencies. Employers subject to emergency planning requirements also must have the emergency response plan, and however, the employees will evacuate the employee with the danger area of the wind, but the emergency curve would not permit any of the other employees to assist in the handling of the emergency, except that they have the developing, implementing, and plan, making the plan available for inspection. They provide an emergency action plan in accordance with Title 29 CFR 1910-38A. Employer emergency response plan must address the minimum of the following areas to the extent that they are not addressed elsewhere. Pre-emergency planning coordinated with the outside parties, personal role lines, facility training, communication, emergency recognition, prevention, safety, distance, pervasive of the refuge site, and security control of the evacuation routes and procedures, decontamination, emergency medical treatment, the first aid of the emergency, alterating response procedure, the criteria, response, and follow up the personal protective equipment, emergency response equipment. All right, emergency response organization employers must be the local emergency response plan, the state emergency response plan, both of the emergency response plan to avoid the duplication of the items of the emergency response plan properly addressed in the SARA. Title of the 2-3 plan that has been included with the emergency agency employers plan, otherwise kept together for the organization employees' youth. Public agency properly employed with the youth of the subject of the emergency response plan provisions must develop and implement such plan with a handle anticipated the emergency to have the plans in the plan. Place of the before emergency response operation start of the plan must be in writing and must be available to the inspection copying of the organization employed with the representative of the personnel. Alright, so it's facility emergency response plan going to the state of emergency response plan commission, facility emergency response plan, local emergency plan commission plan, department plan annex. Hazard Unit Emergency Response Plan 190-120-Q1, Pre-Emergency Plan Line Authority, Emergency Recognition, Decontamination, Emergency Medical, Emergency Route Site Security, Emergency Alteration Response Procedure, Critique Response, Follow-up, Personal Protective Equipment, Safe Distance Guidelines. All right, elements of the Emergency Response Plan. There are many elements for the response agency must develop the emergency response plan. Law enforcement agency that may have the responsible the following must develop an emergency response plan for unseen coordination with control of the emergency access of evacuation running site security crowd control, authorizing notifying the protection public, performing evacuation fire service the most intensive of the fire service to give the half of the work of the contamination area that must be developed the emergency response plan. They describe the guidelines on scene core command suppression of the containment over the control of the establishment of the zone site characters to other functions. Medical service must lift the procedure with the regard with the EMS, the sterilization protocol with the hazmat, and service of the EMS, the emergency response plan must include gathering information, chemical exposure, measure of the pre- and post-exposure vital sign with the maintaining records, monitoring health and staff of the respondent, monitoring health and staff of the public, and providing medical treatment on-site, shelter, finding necessary transportation, medical facility. Environmental, depending on their capability, the environmental agency may perform a wide variety of functions of the hazmat incidents. Some take performed of these agents for which the emergency response plan must have developed, include the monitoring and analysis of the environment, and providing technical guidance to the system, monitoring cleanup activity, calculating any potential exposure to the respondent and public, Red Cross and other volunteer agencies, public and private relief agency, the other assistance with personnel who are evacuated from their homes, provide the basic necessity of the life of the incident that runs within the core of the relief of the agency. The emergency response plan may include providing shelter, supplying cots, pills, blankets, distributing clothing, and distributing food. Regardless of the agency, of the agency's emergency response plan, allow the agency to meet the responsibility outlined in the local emergency plan response planning commission plan. We'll determine whether the agency or the community the responsible to describe the emergency response plan. Consider the three items. First of all, performing the duty of the equipment necessary, adequate training to accomplish the task and comply with the OSHA regulation. Termination is an important phase of the end. Any hazard incident that is not overlooked, develop the end plan with the ordinary termination and recovery from the incident. Alright, summary. Personal safety is foremost concern with the emergency response plan. Especially true with the hazard of the incident due to the possibility of the widespread area of the jurisdiction becoming involved with a large number that the response plan and see if the proper well-written plans will give the incident command guidance for the response. Emergency response plan works to ensure the safety and effective of the response with the possibility of emergency response plan. Crucial element with any responsible may require more thought and effort. Civil action may be taken again for the community that failed to plan and plan effectively. Remember, while individual ICP incident commands may not be participate directly in the formulation of the plans needed to accomplish the duties within the plan, incident command must review the critique of the plan and ensure the both of the ability to operate with the documents guideline facility review the critique of the exercise of the plan could expose the incident command to legal action, considerable fines and other legal actions have been imposed by the government and even the individuals under current laws or regulations. State Emergency Response Plan Commission, Federal Emergency Response Plan 190-120-B4, Terrier 2 Reports Emergency Plan Community Right to Know Act, Local Emergency Plan Commission, Extreme Hazard Substance Emergency Notification, Fire Agency, Local Enforcement Agency, Public Works Agency, the Emergency Response Agency Standard Operation Procedures and Recommended by the Hazmat Material Unit, Emergency Response Plan, Emergency Response Agency Site Control Plan, back to Local Emergency Response Plan. Training. As in the incident command may not be involved putting together an emergency response plan, they may not directly involve the training of each of the individual of their organization, more than they will not be more into the direct involvement of the training other agency personnel. Our potential incident commands must be aware of the training level of the personnel of the potentially involved with an incident. No potential IC with the incident command fire department would ever allow the police officer to attempt with the rescue of the trapped victim, civilian with the fire unless the officer with the properly trained with the use of the personal protective equipment consigns to the incident command should not allow any firefighter to attempt the operation with which the firefighter has not been properly trained. Incident involved with the penalty with the personnel vary for the agency of the elf of the different responsibility of the mice human the impossible task. However, the youth of the incident command system delegates responsibility for the others within the system allowing the incident command to concentrate the managing the incident. Training levels for the responder must remain written in agency plan standard operation procedure. The incident command should have a review of this information. Alright, federal statutory requirements. And I'm going to pause the tape there. All right, continuing the reading, federal statutory requirements. States must file with the two identical federal regulations training responders over the work over the hazard material and waste of OSHA 29 CFR 1910-120Q and EPA Title 40 CFR 311. Amendment Superfunding Program Comprehensive Environmental Response Facility Liability Act 1986 and the SARA Title 1 Section 126 mandated these regulations. The current training status for the emergency responder must be assessed before they can take it and respond with the incident command or respond with assuming the ensuring compliance with the OSHA and the EPA regulation required to climb to the new base level of training. All responders must receive some level of the training. Untrained personnel cannot legally perform functions of the contaminated area with the decontamination immediate area of the incident. Very important over the required training time of these regulations are minimum each of the cover the response level of the competency behavior of the competency proficiencies are much more critical than their immediate mere training hour, the employer has responsibility to ensure the responder has competency in addition to the employer with a certified that the responder is competent and document that fact. Five levels of training mandated by OSHA regulation. First responder awareness not specified object of the awareness of competency of the first responder operation 8 hours and show competency. As mere material technician 24 hours of show competency. Has material specialist 24 hours show competency. On-site incident command 24 hours show competency. Annual refresher training is required at all levels of training. During planning stage, some of the should review the training level of the various personnel with the respondent to the incident of the need, both additional training, upgrade training at the beginning. Personnel to the higher level become the parent of the one shall not allow the respondent to operate at the level higher than the respondent's training. For instance, the operational level of the respondent shall enter the hot zone in there. Intent plunging and patching, otherwise stopping to leave with the offensive of the action will require the training level of training, properly training, pre-assigned roles, respondent, abilities, regular drill that makes them sure available to personnel that they operate properly and safely. First responder awareness. First responder awareness are individuals who are likely to witness and discover the relief that has resulted in the primary function to notify of the property disorder that has reached out of the current state appropriately respond to the manager established for the isolation and with the deny entry for the inappropriate people. Personal awareness level the most demonstrate of the commons we recognize the presence of the identified of the hazard material they involved with an incident that they must understand the hazard material error, the risks associated with the during an incident, with what the potential results may be with the risk created by an incident. They also must understand their role in emergency response plan and be able to recognize the need of additional resource, including this information and the notifications. First responder operational level. The first responder operational level will provide the initial response aid for the protecting the people, the property, environmental doom, and the hazmat relief, the function of the defense mode, the function of the containment, the relief, the keeping it from spraying with a safe distance to prevent exposure without trying to stop the relief of the group. Typically include all firefighters, may include the emergency medical personnel, police, of the private sector, employed, but depending on the duty of the individual, must perform first responders at operational level. They must be familiar with emergency operation plans over the operator, but be able to link in with the employer's command system. Defines of action involved with the notification possible evacuation, not plugging, patching, cleanup of the spill, leaking materials, appropriate actions include, but are not limited to fire suppression, elimination, ignition, source vapor suppression, digging and diking and averting to keep clear release of the contaminated confined area to stop the leak, but if it can be done remote shutoff. Operation personnel receives training with the basic habit of the risk assessment, technically a section of the use of appropriate personal protective equipment to provide with the employer with the basic understanding of the hazmat team, with the training, with the defense of the operation, use the resource of the equipment available to them, get them through with the explanation of all standard operation procedure, operation level of the employee that may perform decontamination if they receive the proper training and required to perform this function. Hazmat material technician. Hazmat material technicians are a personnel who is responding to the relief of the potential relief in order to stop the relief of the scene of the more aggressive offensive of the mode of the operation than the first response over the operational level that may approve the relief of the dry, the plug with the patch in, and other fashions to stop it. Training includes use of the appropriate chemical protective clothing. Trainees must not know how to carry out the emergency response plan, how to function with the intermittent Incident command system make basic termination procedure that may be able to classify, identify, verify the known unknown hazard material by using monitoring equipment. Other than survey instrument, the technician must be able to select using the proper protective equipment and provide with an understanding of the beginning of the proper decontamination procedure. The technicians may further have understanding knowledge of the basic chemical, toxicological terminology, and behavior. All right, hazard material specialist. If the hazard material specialist performs activities similar to those of the technician, except for the specialist responsible for the quarry, the greater depth of the knowledge substance involved, the special may act with the liaison, federal, state, local, governmental authority regarding site activity. Group responders, including personnel who are the hazmat team leaders, officers who specialize with industrial response personnel. It's important to note that the definition of the technician and specialist are not clearly defined, with some of the overlap and currently depending on the interpretation regulation on scene incident commander. The incident command assumes the control of this incident scene with the BM of the first responder. Normally, if the individual fire chief, police officer, plant safety manager, representative, lead response agent of the class of the responder, including all personnel may fill the command position at some time during the emergency, first responder may act with the initial incident command with initiating a multi-level incident command system with the domain of the personnel of the incident command level. Incident command who have received 24 hours of training at the operational level of the addition will have the knowledge and ability to carry out with the employer of the incident command system. Employers' emergency response plan and the incident of the incident command with the understanding of the hazard risks associated with the operation and conduct the chemical protective equipment, clothing, also well as knowledge importance property of the decontamination procedure with this area will be aware of the state emergency response plan and of the national response framework. Refresher training. Employee training any of the five levels must receive the annual refresher training extended enough to maintain the level of competency for the employer. May choose to have the respondent to demonstrate for the competency rather than attend the formal refresher course than any of the case of the employer must maintain record of the method of the demonstration of this competency. Cleanup operation. After the completion of the emergency response phase of the operation, has the substance that either health hazards contaminated so the other materials need removal. The employer conducting cleanup activities must also follow all regulations drive the health and safety of the cleanup of the personnel. No actual labeling, transportation, treatment, or the disposal of the contaminated items. The incident commandant responsible for the oversight of the possible post-emergency response within the unit until the scene of the turnover of the appropriate authority of the environmental agency for the contractor or the facility for the spilled material of the private employee of the property plan of the workplace for the employee. Against cleanup work off the main guideline of the common reply of the employee must be trained to file with the title 29 CFR 1910-38A and 139 and 1200. In addition, they have received the need of the fee. Safety health training made necessary for the health hazard of the chemical that they may encounter with the task they are to perform. Personal protective equipment what they will wear. Following good safety practices and regulations, qualified individuals should inspect all the equipment before use. Only in serviceable condition should it be used. Confined space entry training. Confined space are defined with the OSHA 29 CFR 146. As those spaces containing have the potential for the containment hazard, the atmosphere containing material with the potential of engulfment, having an internal configuration so that the person can be traveled or become an asphyxiated with the containment safety area. Serious safety or health hazard not designated with a continuous human habitation, having opening large enough to allow the personnel to entry. The enter respondent entering the compliance space the need proper to train with the phone with the regulation train with the consent of the monitoring safety entry with the technique with the rescue of the victims or one of the provision regulations allow the industry to train the employee with the entry with the techniques only not in rescue. This is left with the local fire department and in many cases the incident command must anticipate the training rescue of the down employees instead of the compliance space. All right, National Fire Protection Association Professional Standard. The National Fire Protection Association standard is not regulation, but the consensus standard of the representative of the specific area of the concern of the development. The consensus standard is to give the definition guidance of the proper action and the response. Although they are not mandatory, consensus standards represent the appropriate behavior of the competency as viewed by the representative of the members of the profession. These standards explain how the job is to be done and ensure that they provide the standard of care for the owner that is involved with legal and civil action and resolve the action. As met instance, one will be judged by both mandated regulations and consensus standards. There are two relevant National Fire Protection Consensus Standards. National Fire Protection Association Standard 472 standard with the competency respond with the hazard material weapons with the mass destruction incident grand generated with the National Fire Protection Association Technical Committee with the hazard material establishes specifically knowledge competency level to respond with the personnel, clarify with the response personnel into the level previously discussed. Levels include first responder awareness, first responder operation, hazard material technician, incident command, off-site specialist, employees. All right, National Fire Protection Association 473 standard with the competency of the EMS personnel responding with the hazard material weapons of mass destruction incident standard addresses specifically the competency of the EMS personnel with the and management responder victims hazmat incident. Again, this statement is set up in the fashion similar with the National Fire Protection Association standards. All right, training resources. Federal various government regulations not only mandate the training of hazardous material science, but federal entities provide training resources over the APA, SARA, Title I, Section 126 mandates responders training the hazardous situation. SARA Title III makes funds available for the training, but the FEMA makes some of the training available through the training facility with the National Fire Academy, and in this part, other department agencies also make some of the training available to the Department of Labor, the OSHA, DOT, and the other federal agencies that have training available to response personnel. Complete guide available to federal training is the Digest Federal Training Hazmat Material, or FEMA 134 State. In most instances, the two state agencies will help lead with providing training with the response with the hazmat into the state firing training active with the state office of emergency services. Funding is available to both planning and the training with the hazmat material, the Transportation Uniform Safety Act of 1990, Hazmat Material Transportation Act as amended. Training grant money is available at the state level of the SARA Title III, Section 305A. One check with the Governor, Office of the State Emergency Response Commission for the availability with the appropriate state agency to contact training and planning funds. All right, liability under OSHA and EPA and Environmental Protection Association regulation. The public employee with the emergency response organization failed to comply with the applicable requirement of the federal law regulation governing the hazmat response plan with the ensign of the OSHA and Environmental Protection Agency may levy fines and penalties against the governmental unit. These federal requirements should impose the obligation on the employer but do not provide the civil remedy against the first responder or public officials. All right, summary. Common sense, the federal regulation both require all responders to be trained to perform and their assigned regulation respond with the incident commander reminders of the follow these guys, OSHA, the EPA, with a published guideline with the describe the competence and the need to perform the various duties safely while responding to the hazmat incident. National Fire Protection Association produce the consensus standards specifically describe response, competency, action, incident command, do well with the member. Follow these guidelines, failure to do so would leave the litigation penalties worse yet. Such negligence could lead to the loss of life, something every incident commander must work to prevent. All right, and that was the unit one standard of care. Possibly.